Hi, my name is Chris, and I'm here to help you stay connected. Voice over internet service has been gaining in popularity over the past number of years. It's great for making inexpensive phone calls, as well as being able to take your phone number wherever you go now. There's been two major stumbling blocks, though, that have really stopped VoIP acceptance worldwide. That's been the client. There are two types of client. There is your soft phone and your hard phone. Soft phones are essentially software programs that run on your computer. Things like Skype, most people are familiar with. It's a software program on your computer, allows you to make phone calls. Great thing about it, free phone calls. Downside is you don't always take your computer around the house with you. So it's a lot harder to use it as your main phone. The other option, of course, is hardware phones. Much more familiar, easy to use, and all of the VoIP configuration is baked right into it. It makes it really easy. But, of course, you're often tethered, unless you have a cordless phone that allows you to walk around, but even then that can be limited. So, in this video, we're going to show you how we can merge two of them together and create one device, your smartphone. Now, yes, you can get an app for your smartphone that will allow you to make your VoIP phone calls, but in this video, we're going to talk about a hidden feature in Android stock firmware that allows you to make SIP, which is VoIP phone calls, directly from the dialer. So let's take a look. For this demonstration, we're going to be using the Nexus 5. Currently, this one is running stock Android Lollipop 4.4.4. So in order to access this feature, you go into your phone and you click on the dialer feature. And in the top, you'll see your search bar. Up to the side, you'll see a little microphone and three vertical dots. That's what we want to click. So click your three vertical dots and you have a little drop-down menu. Press the bottom one, which is settings. So press that, and we're into our settings. So let's take a closer look and see what we do in here. From your settings menu, we're going to go into the calls section. In here is all the settings for your calls, such as call forwarding and such, but we're going to look at calling accounts, the very first one. In here, this is where we're going to be making all the SIP configurations. Now, to set up our account, we're going to hit SIP accounts. As you can see, I already have one here. We're going to go through and add an account just to show you what you'll be doing here. Now, if you have a VoIP provider or if you have an extension on a VoIP system, you should already have this information, your username. You'd enter it in here, your password, which you enter here, and the server. The server is either the IP address of where you're connecting to or the domain name of the server that you're connecting to, and that's where you'd enter it. Your optional settings, don't worry about this. There's a lot of settings that need to be that are in here. Really don't need to change. I've never had to do it unless your VoIP provider specifically says you need to make some adjustments in here. Otherwise, just leave it as is. Next thing you do is you're going to want to hit save. I'm just going to back out. I want to show you what my settings for here would be. So as you can see, I got my username, my password's in here, the server is already in there, and as I said earlier, the optional settings I've just sort of kept them as is. I'm going to back out here. And then, that's it, this should be registered. Now, there's a few more settings we're going to make before we continue on. Receive incoming calls. If all you're doing is placing outbound VoIP calls for saving money here and there, you can probably keep that checked off. But if you want to actually receive calls and make it useful like a full phone, we're going to have that checked. It does use more battery life, but honestly, I've never noticed that much of a major difference. The very top feature, make calls with. There's three options. There's my mobile provider, the extension which I'm using for, and ask first. So what this will do is anytime you place an outbound call, it will choose which one it is you're making the calls on. So for example, if I hit 410, which is the SIP extension I have, then anytime I made an outbound call and I was connected to the server, it would always put it through that. Or if it's my mobile provider, it would always put it through that. If I click ask first, and every time I place an outgoing call and it has the SIP connection, then it's going to ask you, do you want to do it through your mobile provider or do you want to do it through your SIP connection? So then you can choose which one of those you want to be doing. And but also on that, using SIP calling, if you want to make it for all calls, which is anytime you dial a number, it will connect through SIP, or only for SIP calls, which is if you're only connecting to like the extension at the IP address or extension at domainname.com, that's what that is for. And that's it. There's everything should be set up. So you can just back out now and go back to your main screen. That's it. You should be all set up now. Let's try a test call. So I can use my phone, as you may have saw in my previous video. Dialing through to my phone. This is a pure VoIP call happening within the network. Hello. 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 Now, if I want to call back, you'll see when I enter my menu, you may not be able to see that, but it's got the extensions. If I hit call back, there we go. So I just hit extension 250, which was our test extension for my previous videos, and that's what's dialing through here. Hello. And there you go. There you have it. That is how you make a soft phone out of an Android phone. If you haven't already checked them out yet, check out my other videos. I've got a couple that might be of interest to you, especially if you like this video. I've got one up here on how to set up a Asterisk-based VoIP system. If this is starting to interest you and you want to get your Android phone set up, it helps if you have connection. And a good way to test that out is with an Asterisk-based VoIP system. Also, I have one on how to set up extensions into that VoIP system, and you should see that link over here. And if you like this video and you want to see how to program one of these, then check out the video down here. That'll tell you everything you need to know about how to program a hardware-based SIP phone. Thanks. Let's connect.